Hello students, today we are going to discuss a very important topic about the quarks. What are quarks, how the quarks were discovered, and what are the properties of the quarks. Quarks are the elementary particles just like the leptons, and these particles are indivisible, inaccessible, invisible, and they are very light particles just as the leptons. So, let us study about the quarks. So, in 1964, the two physicists independently proposed the existence of these subatomic particles that were named as quarks. The physicists were Murray Gell-Mann and George Zwigg. They were independently working on the theory of the strong interaction symmetry for the elementary particle physics. So, what they studied that the hadrons were bind together by the very strong forces, and the particles that were responsible, the hadrons were made up of certain particles which had properties of the charm, which had the properties of the flavor, which had the property of certain colors. So on those basis of these properties, the particles, the subatomic particles were named as quarks. So what are the quarks? So, quarks were the elementary particles that are permanently inaccessible. They are inaccessible and they are invisible in the same sense that the leptons are invisible. And since the leptons are regarded as the point particles, so these quarks are also regarded as the point particles, and the quarks have no internal structure. These quarks have no internal structure. So this was very, very fascinating about the quark particles. So the quarks were supposed to be of the fractional charge. It was not having a one value multiple of the electronic charge or the positive multiple of electronic charge, but it was a fractional value of the electronic charges. So the quarks were found to be of the six types. The quarks were up, U, down, charm, strange, top and bottom. As you can see, there are six quarks here, and these six quarks had their anti-quarks also named the same, just by the anti, replacing their name by anti. So it is anti-up, anti-down, anti-charm, anti-strange, anti-top, anti-bottom. So up, down, charm, strange, top, bottom. And since we are shown that these are having the fractional charges, so up, charm and top are having a fractional charge of positive 2 by 3 of E, whereas the anti-up are having a fractional charge of minus 2 by 3 E, anti-charm minus 2 by 3 E, and anti-top also minus 2 by 3 E. Similarly, the downs were having the down, strange, and the bottom were having a fractional charge of negative 1 by 3rd E, and the anti-down, their anti-particles, anti-down, anti-strange, anti-bottom were having a charge that is opposite to their particles, that is positive 1/3 of the electronic charge. So the quarks and the anti-quarks were having the fractional charges. It was found that since the quarks apply to the hadrons family, so hadrons consisted of mesons and baryons. So each baryon, where baryon consisted of the nucleons and the hyperons, so each baryon is made up of three quarks. Each baryon particle is made up of three quark particles. So these are the list of the quark particles. So each baryon is made up of three quarks, and each antibaryon, that is the antibaryon particle, is made up of three anti-quark particles. That is very interesting, very fascinating. And the mesons are made up of one quark and one anti-quark. So baryon is made up of three quarks, antibaryon made up of three anti-quarks, meson is made up of one quark, one anti-quark. So how interesting it is. So since we have assigned the baryon number to the baryon particles, antibaryons are having the baryon number as minus 1. And since one baryon is made up of 3 quarks, so one quark will have a baryon number of 1/3 of the baryon number. So that is why we are writing here, the quarks are assigned a baryon number of B equal to 1 by 3. because one baryon particle is made up of three quarks, so one quark will be assigned a baryon number of 1/3 of the baryon number. So baryon number is 1/3 for the quark, and the baryon number for the anti-quark will be -1/3. Okay, so quarks and anti-quarks, these quarks, anti-quarks are also having a spin. They are moving with a left-handed spin or a right-handed spin. So the spin assigned, number assigned to the quarks and anti-quarks is +½, is equivalent to half, where it could be left-handed or right-handed. So there is a strong interaction between the hadrons, where hadrons, I have already discussed that it is a family of baryons and mesons. So the strong interaction between the hadrons is due to the interaction of these quarks, and these quarks and every interaction has an exchange particle or an exchange medium between them that are holding the particles together. So the exchange particle that are responsible for these hadrons to be tightly interacted, to be bound together, so those exchange particles are known as the gluons. So these exchange medium is the gluons, and as the word suggests, there is a glue word. Glue word means that it is sticking, it is a sticky substance. So these gluons will stick the hadrons together, and they will bind them together. They are responsible for tightly binding the particles together. So the gluons are the intermediate particle, exchange particles that are binding the hadrons together. So what about the gluons? So gluons are the massless particles. They do not have any mass, and they are moving with very high speed, that is the speed of light. And each gluon carries a persistent color. It has a color and an anti-color also. So it has been found that when the quarks are interacting with the exchange of these gluons, they are emitting gluon or they are absorbing gluon. So the absorption and the emission of the gluons is imparting the color to the quarks. So quarks are also having certain colors. The blue, red and green are the primary colors. So these colors are imparted by the exchange of the gluons. So the gluons are facilitating the quarks' color, and these gluons are very light particles, and therefore they are regarded as the light particle, just as the leptons are light particles. So the gluons are also light in number. What is that? The quark possess the properties of colors. So the quarks are basically in the three primary colors, that is the red, green and blue. And the anti-quarks are present in the anti-colors, that is the anti-red, which is cyan, anti-green, that is magenta, and anti-blue, that is the yellow color. So the quarks possess the characteristics of the colors. Next, all the three quarks present in the baryon, because baryon is formed by three quarks and anti-baryon is formed by three anti-baryons. So all the quarks in one particular baryon will have three different colors. Similarly, the anti-baryon, which is constituted of the three anti-quarks, will have the three anti-colors. And since it is following the color rule, so it will be not overruling the Pauli's exclusion principle. Instead, it is obeying the Pauli's exclusion principle, as if all of them are in the different states, and even if two or three are in the identical, their color will be different. Therefore, the Pauli's exclusion principle will be obeyed. A meson. We have talked about the baryon here, where the baryon was constituted of three quarks, whereas in the meson, it is a constitution of one quark and one anti-quark. And that also, since the quark is of one color, anti-quark is of anti-color, so the meson is always a colorless particle. So meson consists of a quark of one color, an anti-quark of the corresponding anti-color. So color anti-color mixes up to form a colorless substance. So therefore mesons are always colorless. And since we are dealing about the interaction of these strong particles, of the interaction of the quarks, and the theory that explains the interaction of the quarks is called the quantum chromodynamics. Chromo is for the color dynamics. So the study of the quarks is called as the quantum chromodynamics. So it explains the interaction of the quarks with each other. It explains how the charged particles, the quarks are the charged particles. We have already studied that they possess a charge of either plus minus 2/3 of the electronic charge, or they have the plus minus of 1/3 of the electronic charges. So they are the charged particles and they are interacting with each other, where the color is replacing the charges. So the theory is called as the quantum chromodynamics. So here I have listed the quantum properties of the quarks and the anti-quarks. This is two sections. This is comprising of the quarks and these are the particles of the anti-quarks. So in the quarks we have up, down, charm, strange, top and bottom, and these are the symbols. And these are the anti-quarks, that is anti-up, anti-down, anti-charm, anti-strange, anti-top and anti-bottom. And we have already studied that both the quarks and anti-quark possess the spin half. They have a half spin, and these are the properties that we shall be studying. Electric charge we have already studied, that they possess plus minus of 2 by 3 of electronic charges. So up, charm, top has positive 2/3 of the electronic charge, whereas their antiparticles have minus 2 by 3 of the electronic charge. The down, strange and bottom have negative 1/3 of the electronic charge, where the antiparticles anti-down, anti-strange and anti-bottom possess positive 1/3 of the electronic charge. The baryon number, since one baryon is formed by three quarks, so quark has a baryon number of 1/3 and anti-quarks has a baryon number of minus of 1/3. So all the quarks are having 1/3 baryon number and all the anti-quarks are possessing minus 1/3 of the baryon number. Next is the strangeness. So in the strangeness, we have one strange particle quark. So the strange number for the strange is minus 1. And the anti-strange particle, that is the anti-quark, possesses a strangeness number of 1. Where rest all the particles, all the quarks or anti-quarks are possessing a zero value for the strangeness number. The charm is also a property. So the charm particle possess, charm quark possess a charm number of 1, whereas rest all are having a zero number for the charm. And similarly, the anti-charm possess a value of minus 1, rest all the particles possess the zero number. Similarly, the top number is only for the top particle of the quark. So the top particle, top quark, has a number of 1 and rest all have number 0. And similarly, the anti-top has number minus 1, rest all has a number 0. Similarly, the bottom number is represented by B bar. So B bar is for the bottom quark, that is minus 1, and for the anti-bottom the number is 1. Whatever is the number for sign or the value for a particle, it get replaced by a positive or negative sign. It is an opposite sign for the anti-quark. So you can see for strangeness it was minus 1. For anti-quark it is 1. For charm the number is 1. So for the anti-charm it is minus 1. For top it is number 1. For anti-top it is minus 1. For bottom it is minus 1. So for anti-bottom the number is plus 1. So these are the quantum properties of the quarks and their anti-quarks. So now the next property is the composition of the hadrons according to the quark model. So in the hadrons we have the mesons and the baryons. So in the mesons family we have the pions, kions and the eta mesons. So pions are pi naught, pi positive and pi minus. So we know according to the quark model that the mesons are formed by the one quark and by one anti-quark. So it is the combination of a quark and an anti-quark. So we say that pi naught can be found in two ways. It can be either the combination of UU bar or the DD bar. So in this table, in this composition, we shall be discussing about the charge of the various hadrons, the baryon number, the spin and the strangeness. So UU bar, as we know that U has a charge of plus 2 by 3 E. So u bar is minus 2 by 3. So the total charge on the pi naught is 0. And for the DD combination also, we have minus 1 by 3 and 1 by 3. Again, the charge, total charge is 0. For pi positive, it is u into d bar. So it is 2 by 3 and 1 by 3, which is equal to 1. And for pi negative, it is d into u bar. So it is minus 1 by 3 and minus 2 by 3, which is minus 1. For the strangeness number or for the baryon number, we know that the particles have the baryon number 1, 1 by 3, and the anti-quarks has a baryon number of minus 1 by 3. So for all the first letters, first quark, it has a baryon number of 1 by 3, and all the anti-quarks has a baryon number minus 1 by 3. So 1 by 3 and minus 1 by 3 add up to give a baryon number of 0. So we know that the pions or the mesons, kaons, eta mesons are not the baryon family. So the baryon number is 0. For the spin, the quark is, if the quark is upspin, the anti-quark is of the downspin. So upspin, downspin, upspin, downspin gives a spin value of 0. For eta naught, eta naught is a combination of UU bar plus DD bar minus of 2 SS bar upon root S, root 6. So the charge will be positive, negative, cancel to give a charge 0. Again, the baryon number is again positive and negative. So again, the baryon number is 0. Spin will be upspin, downspin. So again, the spin is 0. And the strangeness is also 0. So for the strangeness, we can say that since only the S quark is the strange particle, U, D is not the strange particles. So the strangeness number is 0 for the U, U bar, D, D bar. It is only the strangeness number for S and S bar, where S is having a strangeness of minus 1 and S bar is having a strangeness of plus 1. So we can see the values. So the kaons are the strange value, strange particles. So for K naught, it is D S bar. So D has a strangeness 0, S bar has a strangeness number plus 1. So the K naught has a strangeness of plus 1. K naught bar has a strangeness number of minus 1 plus 0, that is minus 1. K plus is U into S bar. So U has a strangeness number 0, S bar has a strangeness number of plus 1. So it gives a value of plus 1 strangeness number. And K negative has a strangeness number of minus 1 because it is a combination of S and U bar. So S has a strangeness number minus 1 and 0. So it gives a strangeness value of minus 1. So here we have also depicted the meson, where meson is a combination of a quark and anti-quark, and they exhibit their colors also. And the meson is a colorless particle. So if it is a red quark, then the anti-quark is of the anti-color. So the red and anti-red will cancel out each other to form a It will form a colorless particle. So this is the color scheme of the meson. So we can take any color. So it will always be a colorless particle. Next we come to the baryon family. So in the baryons we have the nucleons and the hadrons. For the nucleons we have shown the particle and antiparticle, and similarly for the hadrons also we can show the assembly for the antibaryons. So for the proton, it is a combination of two U quarks and one D quark. So the charge on it will be 2 by 3, 2 by 3, and D is having a charge of minus 1 by 3 E. So the total is 4 by 3 minus 1 by 3 is 3 by 3, that is plus 1. Baryon number, as we have earlier also spoken, that the baryons, quarks has a baryon number plus 1 by 3 and the anti-baryon has a baryon number of minus 1 by 3. So it is having a baryon number 1 by 3. So 1 by 3, 1 by 3, 1 by 3 gives a baryon number of 1. And we know that the proton has a baryon number plus 1. Similarly, for the antiproton, all the quarks are replaced by the antiquarks. So it is U bar, D bar. So the baryon number will be minus 1 by 3, minus 1 by 3, minus 1 by 3 to give a baryon number of minus 1. And similarly, the charges are also negated. So it is minus 2 by 3, minus 2 by 3 and 1 by 3 to give a charge of minus 1. And similarly, the spins, the two ups and one down give a spin of half. And here the upspin has been inverted to the downs because it is U bar. So down, down and up will give a half value. And the strangeness also, we have UU, D's combination. So it is not a strange particle. So the strangeness number is 0 for the proton and antiproton. Similarly, for the neutron, it is UdV combination, and for the antineutron, it is U bar, D bar, D bar. So we have the charges. So neutron gets a neutral charge, that is the zero value, and neutron has a baryon number plus one, antineutron has a baryon number of minus one. We can see here also the values of the spin. U is up spin, DD is down spin. So 2 down, 1 up gives a value of plus half. And in the U bar, DD bar, D bar, D bar, we get a value of again 1 up, 1 down gets cancelled to give 1 half spin. And the strangeness is also coming out to be 0 because the proton, neutrons, proton, antiproton, antineutron are also non-strange particles. Next we come to the hyperon family. Here we are discussing only the particle, not their antiparticles. The antiparticles are similarly just to replace the quark by their antiquark. So lambda naught is SUD. S is a strange particle, strange quark. So S is minus 1 by 3 charge, U is plus 2 by 3 charge, and D is minus 1 by 3 charge. So 2 by 3 minus 2 by 3 gets cancelled to give a charge value of 0. All are the baryons. So it has a quark, all has a quark value of baryon number of 1 by 3. So it gives a value of 1. So 2 up, 1 down give a spin of half. And the strangeness number for S quark is minus 1. UD has a strangeness value of 0. So we get a strangeness number of lambda naught is minus 1. Similarly for sigma positive, it is SUU combination. So we get a charge of plus 1. So 4 by 3 minus 1 is plus 3 by 3, which is equal to plus 1. It is all the 1 by 3 baryons, so it is giving a baryon number of plus 1. So 2 up and 1 down gives a value of spin half. And again we have a S quark in sigma positive, so again the strangeness number is minus 1. In sigma naught, it is SUD combination, such that the charge comes out to be 0, baryon number is again 1, and 2 up and 1 down gives a value of half spin, and again we have 1s, so we get the strangeness value of minus 1. For the cascade particles, we have two cascade or xi particles, cascade neutral and cascade negative. So cascade neutral have two strange quarks, that is 2s and 1u, so that the charge on the cascade neutral is 0 and the baryon number is 1. 2 up spin, 1 down spin give a spin value of half. And since there are 2 ways, so we have minus 1 2 times. So we get a strangeness value of minus 2 for the cascade neutral. For cascade negative, we have the combination of SSD. So SSD gives a value of the charge value equal to minus 1. And baryon number is plus 1. 2 up spin, 1 down spin gives a value of half spin. And again 2s gives a strangeness value of minus 2. In the omega particle, omega negative particle, we have the combination of 3s. Here three quarks, three strange quarks are assembled together so that we get a charge value of minus 1. Baryon number is again positive 1, and 3 up spins gives a spin value of 3 by 2. So this is a point to be remembered, that omega has a spin of 3 by 2 whereas all others has a spin of half. And since there are 3s particles involved, so the strangeness value is minus 3. So omega has a strangeness number of minus 3. In the color scheme, we know that the baryon is a combination of 3 quarks of 3 different colors. So it is of red, green and blue. So this is the baryon constituency. We are having 3 quarks combined with 3 different colors, so that the Pauli's exclusion principle is obeyed. And in the antibaryon, there are 3 antiquarks, and 3 antiquarks are having the 3 anticolors. So the red has the anticolor of anti-red, that is the cyan. Green has an anticolor of magenta, and the blue has an anticolor of anti-blue, that is yellow. Since you can see also, if the quark is in the positive direction, its antiparticle will be in the downward direction. If it is moving to the right, the antiquark will move to the left. If it is moving to the left, the antiquark is moving to the right. So this is how the baryon anti-baryon is formed using the color schemes also. So it was found that till now no quark has been isolated. But in the Stanford Accelerator Center, there had been found with a grant grand electron microscope that quarks content has been seen when the protons and neutrons were seen. So we could detect the traces of the quarks that were much smaller particles than the protons and neutrons itself. So these were the various properties that you have discussed for the quark model. Thank you.